Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Total War Wins. As always, I am D, and unfortunately, if you remember the last episode, our forces kind of got destroyed. Now granted, we did have Durthu kill two of the great leaders of Chaos on his own. Well, not on his own, he did have support, but you know what I mean. But yeah, so Colas did die, unfortunately. She's actually completely gone, which is the problem. But still, I took two armies against three, and I won. At first. Can I offer assistance? Actually, Findal, I want you to stay in Karaburg. I need more...
These are dark times.
Dyes. Let's go ahead and start recruiting for you. I have 12 amber to work with. Three. I'm going to spend half my amber on Dite's army. Don't want Glade Riders. Sisters of the Thorn? Huh. And one of you. One of you. Alright, in four turns, Dide's army will be enough. Actually, you know what? On second thought, Findal, head back to Helmgart. Start defending my borders. Isil, I'll head up to... Why are you in encampment? Three of my armies. Where's my fourth army? Oh, I can upgrade this. Just let me get Swift Shiver Shards and Hagbane Tips for Glade. Well, that's for Deepwood Scouts and Glade Riders. Is Doden even still alive? I don't think so. Oh, Midland has damaged buildings. Of course they do. Well, I'm probably going to be attacked really soon. Break the alliance with the Empire? No! They're much more useful to me than you are right now. Weissman is screwed. I'm not even gonna fight this, I'm just gonna... Did they at least kill anybody? Nope. And it's 7 against over 100 times their number. It was just shy of 110 times their army. So... Estalia. Do I even have I have a defensive alliance with Estalia. Tilia's defensive. It's a military ally. Military ally with Tilia, yes, because that'll give me even more amber. The amber is important, as I hope I've made it clear by now, because let's be honest here, folks. Without the amber that I get. Let's see. Oh right, it's because I had them all going after Archaon. Well, let's give them a new target, shall we? Britonia. And Carcassonne. The Empire, which is actually much smaller than I was hoping. You guys in there. Estalia. Also for the Chaos Sorcerer, and you know what, I'll have Tilia do it as well. And finally, Von Karstein. Although, as I pointed out in one of my streams, Manfred is actually the ultimate, one of the ultimate reasons that the world ends. And that's actually not me being, that is not me being bitter or anything. He actually does have a direct hand in the end of the old world, and the becoming of the Age of Sigmar. Who's the highest level? Findal's 11, Dyde is 12. How can I assist you? He's got a Shrieking Blade. Have a Luckstone. Does Dyde just not get a mount? Oh, he does eventually. Or he can. Okay, he can actually get up to the Great Eagle. Where is my what the? Razor Sack the Bay of Blades. There's no way I'm getting there. Where's my other army? I'm guessing it's because I'm guessing it's Durthu's army. Oh well. Military access for the Empire? Yes. Because they had to go through Karaburg to get to the enemies. I'm gonna see about making an ally out of the dwarves. Okay, so I make, that's what I'm exporting, so I would make 603. And yeah, okay. Non-aggression back with the border princes, yes. I'm going to take as many positive diplomatic actions as I can. Ulf. Yeah, I don't have walls or anything to defend there. I prefer to have good defensive fortifications with me. I think one of my guys should be able to deal with Ulf. Findal. Turns and Dyde will have a full army. Finally. And they just turned right around and ran away. Wait, they got beaten. No, I forgot. I'm trying to make the dwarves my allies. Alright, so Chaos is actually currently beating the shit out of the Empire. That's not worrying or anything. Sigvald. More trade. Oh, military access. That'll work too. Well, the northern half of the Empire's on fire. And the Bray herds are coming. Really? Is this really the time for that?
Fury Fair.
Finding pathways. This might go poorly.
Orders?
How long until Durthu's back? Should be about, yeah, one turn. Right, first order of business. The Dwarf Realms.
Do not sully my presence any longer than you must.
I'm trying to make it so we all survive this. Ugh, silly, annoying dwarf. Sigvald's coming in. Yeah, run. You ran the wrong way. Well, Astalia and Tilia look like they're coming towards me. I'm getting a ton of trade. Granted, I have a lot of trade goods to work with, so. The red horns are dead. Durthu is back. Can I recruit him in Paravon? Yes, I can. Alright, you guys have three armies? Let's see if I can get my three armies to join up.
Lord of the Glade.
Lady of Athelmoran.
Lord of Athelmoran. My journey begins.
I still like the idea of having a Treemen that is basically constantly on fire. Alrighty. Oh, wait. I forgot about Strathoat. I completely forgot about him. He's the Ancient of Deliandra. Trade with non-Wood Elf factions, which is how I'm getting so much money. That would explain where the fourth army was. Make him even more dangerous. What does a branch wraith do? Oh, they have access to the Lore of Life, but not a lot of it. Shadows, life, or beasts? So you get a Waystalker.
Guardian of the Deep. Magnus.
Your job? Vilgen is to become basically Durthu's lieutenant. I love how they're basically just all of them are just importing things from me. None of them are actually exporting anything to me because I've already got most of it. Oh crap, Colec's back. And yeah, fall back, Dyth. This is not looking terribly good right now. They're coming straight at Athaloran. Yeah, I know I'm overdoing that, probably, but I could probably do more damage than killing two, but I don't want to waste time right now.
Oh, mighty lord, the fates have surely selected you for greatness. Thanks to my guidance, your tremendous power grows as if driven by
something. Yeah, because you're not...
Magnificent, my lord. The Oak of Ages flourishes under your benevolence.
What does that actually do for me again? Plus 4 public order, minus 20% upkeep for all units, can do the confederation, reduction in corruption by 9, plus 3 hero recruit rank, and it also gives me a much larger garrison in the area, so I need... Actually, if I get rid of... Say if I got rid of... He's got 6, that'd be 11. All I would need to do is get one more amber from somewhere. Take Karaberg. Colonize. Alright, I'm gonna lose a ton of troops here, but sorry, Dyth. Yeah, there we go. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, some weirdness might have happened there, yeah, I know. You might notice that it's a bit of a weird cut. It's because I didn't realize until about halfway through that I'd run out of space on my external hard drive, so I had to start up the recording again. This is actually the second half. It's about 12 minutes long. Speaking of which, I need to start my timer. A few extra seconds won't hurt. Hopefully. I did manage to win the battle at Helmgart, and Isolal threw them back pretty hard. She's got to run now. Dyth. I don't think I have anybody else. Except Findal. I did come up with an idea for how to deal with this though. Because this is a quite intimidating army they've got coming after me, so... I'm gonna ask my allies to step in. Estalia and Tilia especially should be more than willing to help out with this because they hate the Beastmen more than I do. And Manfred.
Greetings. What do you require of the Carra's uncle?
Worth a shot. Although I've got to survive for 9 more turns.
Lord of Athelmoran.
Dyth, you need more troops. 3 Deepwood Scouts. two Treekin, and actually let's make it just three Treekin. Yeah, Isilov managed to stand up and beat back pretty much the entire enemy army on her own. So she's going, actually, you know what, undo that. Growth of the forest. So yeah, she managed to throw back Colex, Sun Eater, and not Banehasser, no, there was another guy. I killed that one. Break a non-aggression pact with the Border Princess for 300. No. I need all of my allies right now. I need to not be at war with random people. Okay, this is versus the Everchosen. Hopefully this goes okay. This is probably going to be the end of the episode. Right here is Findal versus Archaon. Okay, let's see. I got three units of Marauders, so my flying units are actually going to be very useful here. Here's hoping this all works. I am actually a little bit nervous about this because I'm on the final stretch. There's those turns until the Oak of Ages is ready. That is how long I've got, and I've got to win the fight before I can win the whole map, this whole campaign. We'll see how long it takes, though. If I can manage it. The battle of Or the battle for the Tree of Age, for the Oak of Ages, is definitely what I'm gonna have to do myself. Alright, Findal's got some pretty decent troops. Chosen himself right there. He doesn't have a hell cannon, so that's a plus in my favor. He does have magic, which is actually going to hit a little bit. Those are Marauder horsemen. This is the part where I lose because my armies are now scattered. My troops are now scattered all over the place. My Treemen's going to die. He didn't flee, he got killed. Oh, my dryads are currently fighting off chaos trolls, and actually doing well. Chariot. No, I thought we'd give them nice fruit baskets. Of course we're gonna kill them. Seriously? Guess what you guys get to do? Draw your swords and get the hell in there. Good, make them do it. And there goes the army. Still, I managed to hurt him a little bit. Took out at least one chariot entirely. Let's see. Yeah, once we load back in, that'll be the episode. It could have gone worse. Could also have gone much better. But the point is, Findle did what I needed him to do, which was to slow down Archaon. Either one works. If he'd won, Archaon would be off the field for a bit. If he lost, which he did, Archaon's troops have to slow down to heal up some. Well, short of the computer, like, being blatant about its cheating. The AI does cheat a little bit in this game, I'll admit. Not as much as some people probably think, though. Come on, almost there. Yep, and Golex on Montfort. Not gonna fight this one. Oh, what the? Oh. Okay, looks like we're gonna have... You know what, actually, we're gonna auto-resolve. Kolek falls. Actually, no, Kolek lives. No, actually, he fell. That's interesting. Carcassonne is going to war... with the Jagged Horn. Not a war I need right now, but if I did that, if I didn't join them, I would lose the alliance, so. Alrighty. Alrighty. That'll be the episode done, ladies and gentlemen. If you enjoyed the show, please be sure to like or favorite the video. You can also leave a comment down below if you have anything you'd like to say. And if you want to keep up with me and never miss any of my current series, then please be sure to click the subscribe button down below or the icon at the end of the video. As for that, folks, I have been D. We're close to the end game now. So good night, and good gaming.